everybody. Hey, you guys, we're letting more people jump on. Versus Idol. Woo! Honey, it's about to be popping tonight. So it's Saturday night. I got my friend Vincent Powell here. Ignore our phoneness. We're trying to get everybody connected on all the different places and all the pages. Because we want everyone as possible to be able to see what's going on tonight. That's too far.
Okay, great.
You got it. My baby's working production for me back there. Thank you, baby. I appreciate you. Woo! You look good. Go see yourself. Here's a quick shot, too.
Oh!
Okay. We got shininess. We got music. I want to say thank you to my manager and one of my closest friends, David. He made this awesome promo video for us, which I'm trying to be able to see if y'all can see it. Let's see if I tilt the screen enough. Y'all are able to see the screen. Okay, there we go. Hi, everybody. Welcome. Oh, Voices of Hope is on here. Oh my gosh, we got so many people on here. This is awesome. Hello, everyone. So for those of you on Vincent's channel, my name is Christina Wells. I was a semi-finalist on America's Got Talent in 2018, which was season 13. And for those of you on my channel, this is the amazing Vincent Powell II. Hey.
My name is Vincent Powell. It's two on Facebook because I got two pages, but I'm the only one.
Oh, I got you. So this is Vincent Powell, and he was a finalist on American Idol.
Season 12, 2013.
Look at how he had to help me because I got messed up a little bit. Okay. So, you got your microphone?
Yeah.
You ready to do this? No, it's for you first, honey.
Oh, it's for me.
Yes, that's right. So, let me tell you what we're doing. So, we're about to take y'all on a little memory lane. We're going to play the songs we sang on the TV.
On the TV.
So what we're going to do is we're going to start out with Vincent's first audition in season 12.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to work our way, which this wasn't your first time to audition for American Idol.
Right. I auditioned for the show 6 times. I made it the 5th and 6th time.
See? So those of you who are out there talking about they just got on because they tried one time, I auditioned for AGT only once, but I auditioned for American Idol one time, and I auditioned for The Voice twice. Mm. So we all been out there beating them streets before we finally got some TV time.
Yeah, you're going to get a lot of no's. That's what it is.
I know. I tell people that you need to meet a certain number of no's, so you need to go get them done.
Yes,
so
right.
Go out and audition a whole bunch of times so you can get the 50 no's you need so that you can get the 51 will be a yes.
That's right. You got to pay your dues.
Yes. Pay the dues. Give some dues. Take some dues. Whatever it is. So first we're going to go into Mr. Vincent's first audition.
The cameras are rolling. The judge is just about set. So let's get the day started in San Antonio.
Well, I was nervous.
First up was returning contestant Vincent Powell. For him, getting a golden ticket would only fulfill half his dream.
How you been, Vincent?
Trying to be like you, man.
Come on, now.
Make
it happen.
You was yourself.
There's a song.
I am in love with Mariah Carey.
I love you, Ryan.
I have my posters all over my room. And I used to be like, God, please let me be Mariah Carey one day. And look at it here, I'm gonna meet her today.
Well, let's go. Good luck with the audition,
oh
Vincent. We'll see you in a minute. Make it happen.
Oh, I'm gonna be so stressed out.
Hi.
Hello, how are y'all doing?
Good, how you doing?
Pretty good. Just happy to be here.
What's your name?
Vincent Powell.
Vincent. And what are you gonna sing today?
I want to do Rock Me Baby.
Okay.
Rock me, baby. Rock me all night long. Said I want you to rock me, baby. Rock me all night long.
Hello.
Well, say
Song.
That was fantastic.
So the funny thing about that audition was, so you go through several different auditions. It's really like four or five. And so the audition before that, they told me to wear the same thing. So you know, if anybody knows me, that I am a person that buys things, and if I wear it one time, I'm taking it back.
And so you ain't supposed to tell them that. You say that you donated.
I got it back.
There you go.
But look, I took the shirt back, and I was like, oh my God. I gotta wear the same shirt. So I was sitting there trying to find that shirt.
No.
Yeah, it was a bad, and then it was a long night. I didn't sleep that night, but yeah, look at God.
Look at God, rock me, baby. Mm-hmm, okay, so.
Come on, Christina, come on.
What's your name and where are you from?
My name is Christina Wells, and I am from Houston, Texas.
And what made you decide to come on America's Got Talent?
Okay, well, I'm 42 years old. When I was 19, I had a dream of being a singer, and I had an opportunity to go and audition. And I got to the very end, and right before they chose the final people, they cut me, and they told me it was because I wasn't the right size.
Wrong, people. Poor choice.
Can I ask you, do you sing for a living? Do you sing professionally?
No, I'm a registered nurse.
She's a nurse.
And I'm a single mom with two boys. Yeah.
And why did you decide to come on the show this year?
This is an awesome opportunity for me to fulfill my dreams and for me to show my boys that nothing should prevent you from making your dreams come true.
Great! Yes!
Thank you
for
saying that. Nothing should prevent you. My favorite part is when she
first started.
Go for
it.
Okay.
Come on, Christina. I believe in you, girl. Take a deep breath.
There's a light in the darkness, though the night is black as my skin. There's a light burning bright,
come on, girl,
showing me the way. But I know where I've been.
Loading.
In the future, there's a struggle we have yet to win. Use that pride in our hearts to lift us to tomorrow. Cause just to sit still would be a sin. Lord knows, come on, let her do it. Woo! Where I be.
I love it.
Can you thanks to my God, cause I know.
Let me tell you. So that song is called I Know Where I've Been. It's from Hairspray. So if you're a Broadway person, I'm going to need you to put some hearts up right now if you love you some Broadway shows. I was Motormouth Maybell way back in 2015. Learned this song. Love it so much. And so whenever I went to go on the show, they were like, we really want you to sing Son of a Preacher Man. And you guys know that song, Billy Ray was a preacher's son. When his daddy will visit, he come along. You know that song? How well I remember. And they were like, this is the song for you. And I'm like, I don't think so. I think that I Know Where I've Been will do so much more.
Right.
And they were like, So then I get to, you get to Hollywood. You got to go meet all the people. You do the music rehearsal. And there's this whole room of people who listen to you sing and then tell you if the song you've chosen is okay.
Right.
You did this,
right,
yes? Right. And I sing Son of a Preacher Man. And they're like, ooh, we really like that one. I'm like, please hold. And then I sang I Know Where I've Been for them, and everyone was like, oh, no, you're right. You're right. That's the song. Because you know why that's the song? Because I believe that song.
It comes from
a deep place inside my body. Because I do know where I've been. I come from Pasadena, Texas. If you're from Pasadena, I need to see some purple hearts because I got purple on. Ooh, purple. I'm seeing it. Purple hearts, please. Pasadena, Texas. I know where I come from. I know the struggles. I was raised very poor. Very poor. Like, didn't have a car till we were much older. Walked to the grocery store carrying grocery bags when I was 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 years old. So on food stamps, I grew up really poor. So now every time I have an opportunity to do anything of the things I dreamed of, to be any of the things, if it's school, if it's my kids, if it's my music, I'm like, I know where I came from. I'm going to take every opportunity. So that's why that song means so much to me. Yes.
Started from the bottom.
Now we're here. Okay. Back to business. Hold on.
Look, we was going to go to the group round, but the group round showcased more people than me. So, you know what I'm saying? It ain't their show today, too. So, I'm going to do a song that I should have sung on Idol.
Okay.
So, basically, Idol showed me, like, it kind of helped me develop who I am.
Yeah, of course.
And so, you know, of course, when I went on Idol, I wanted to be Usher. I wanted to sing all these pop songs or whatever. But they was like, no, you got to do soul. And I was like, well, I sing at church all the time. I don't want to do that. But that's what people, it was more believable. So that's why I've been singing more soul songs. And so this song I did with a church out of San Antonio, Concordia. And it was for basically what's going on right now. The movement change is going to come.
Okay, let's go. Look, boom.
And they put their own spin to it, so, you know. Oh. shade is gonna go.
That's right. So this is what you wish you would have said.
Yeah, all soul, nothing but the soul.
All the time. Now I think also, like you said, this song is amazing because it speaks to the time we have right now. Right, it speaks to the time. And that's about the fact that we do see a change happening right now across our universe.
Right.
Good things, bad things, ugly things, pretty things. Right. And I think it speaks to the fact that we're here today, because the reason that we decided to get together and do this verse is we love to sing together, first of all.
Yes, I love her.
I love you. But also, we really wanted to speak about mental health, which is Mental Health Awareness Month, for those of you who don't know.
Yes.
And if you follow either one of us, you know that we're really big about mental health. And also, August was Anti-Bullying Month. If you follow me, you know that I am a big brand ambassador for anti-bullying. And I usually, I have been working with a company called The Bully Exposed. And tonight, we are benefiting The Bully Exposed. That's why we're doing the Verses, which is a nonprofit organization, a 501c3 nonprofit organization, made to help the survivors of bullying. And so whenever you talk about a change is going to come and talk about the things happening in the world, talk about the quarantine, talking about COVID-19, everybody being in their house by themselves, and the mental health strain that we've all been going through. I know I've been going through it. Like, you see me right now, I got on sparkly makeup, a sparkly dress, and I'm happy. I'm singing a song. We've got lights going. You know, this is where I live in my joy. This is why I feel like I'm living in my purpose. And so being at home and not being able to do this and not being able to connect with all of you guys, it's been really challenging for me. And so I know that my mental health has been going through it. And I know that other people, unfortunately, going back to school, the stressors of that, social distancing, mask, whether you have cool mask or you don't have cool mask, I'm sure there's plenty of bullying going on that I wish we could just stop and realize that everyone's unique identifiers are important, and it's great to be different, right? So if you are really feeling this Verses, we got a bunch more songs for you. We're going to be on here until 10 p.m. Central Standard Time. Please take a moment, hit that Cash App, but it's not for me or Vincent.
Nope.
We want you to hit that Cash App to $ The Bully Exposed number 2.
Oh,
he's going to pin that in his, and I'll pin it in my comments as well.
No, I'm about to Cash App.
Look, he's going to hit the Cash App. That money is going to go to helping this nonprofit organization continuing. What they really do great is they document stories of people who've been bullied and who have survived it, and unfortunately those who have not survived it. Because there are people who lose their lives and lose their jobs and lose their livelihoods to bullying. So if you are feeling what we are talking about and you want to give it, I mean, $1. I'm talking about $1 right now. The Bully Exposed, number 2. On Cash App. Or if you're like, I don't have any money, girl is strapped, she broke from COVID. Hello, that's my name. Then just go over to their page and give them a follow. If you go over to @StopBullyingTogether, Richard, if you're watching this, drop your Instagram handle in there for me. If you're watching, just go give them a follow, because that's supporting them as well. The more followers they have, then you know what happens? They can get verified. And if they get verified on Instagram, then they can become a nonprofit that then you, when you do lives, you can actually do a benefit for them, a fundraiser in your life.
Wow.
So these are huge steps. If you do these two things, either drop $1, a couple of dollars, or if you don't have any money, go into that, go into your Instagram. You can take them a second from the live. We'll be here, and go click follow on their page and then come on right back. So it's my turn.
I can see mine.
Look. Donation. Look at that love. Thank you for that. So my next audition, y'all, Judges Cuts. Look how cute you are. You was belting. No. I was born. You was doing it.
Hello.
Right, here we go.
Introduce yourselves to the audience.
Yes. So my name is Christina Wells. I'm a nurse by day and a singer by night.
Come on, sexy.
And Christina, what's the song you're going to sing?
I'm going to sing Never Enough from The Greatest Showman.
I think this is one of the best songs I've heard in years.
Thank you.
So no pressure.
None at all, no.
Let's do it, Christina.
Okay.
Sammy Cal says my name a whole bunch. Woo! Y'all.
I'm trying to hold my breath. Let it stay this way. Can't let this moment end. All the shine of a thousand spotlights, all the stars we steal from the night sky will never be enough.
clickbait.
Could it be more dramatic? So I'm gonna tell y'all. Did you feel that? Did you feel it?
You know what I'm saying? You want to build every step of the way.
So no, let me tell y'all. Everyone loves this song.
Yeah,
I was not a fan of it. And so when they were like, we'd like you to sing this song, I was like, no. Oh, thank you, though. Like you. I'm like, I want to sing some R&B. I want to sing some soul. That's what I do. And they were like, no. We really we see you singing these inspirational songs. We see you singing these big Broadway songs. Like, this is what we want you to do. And I mean, it's not that I don't love doing that, but you have a vision for when you ever get on TV. So all of you who have ever stood in line to audition, you got a vision in your head. You might have to change that a little bit.
A lot of them in the line got a lot of visions.
Yeah, a lot of us in those lines got some visions, and it don't exactly happen. So they had a couple different songs. A Change Is Gonna Come was on my list, too.
Oh, wow.
Uh-huh. Because I have such a deep voice, so they're like...
Well, I love that song for you.
They did good? Okay, so I will tell you, I will tell you the thing. So I did this, yes. And I was not happy with this performance. This one right here, Mel B was like, you were pitchy, which is my favorite word. Not sharp or flat, but pitchy. And my favorite thing, someone wrote to me and they were like, girl, when someone's claim to fame is a zig, a zig, zig, a zig, ah. She's not going, but anyways, that's not nice. I didn't say that. Never mind. Someone wrote that. But I will say that George Foreman got inducted to the Sports Hall of Fame here in Houston. And he told his family that he wanted someone to perform. And they said to the Houston Sports Awards, who were putting it together, that they wanted someone Jennifer Holliday-like. And they called me. And I sang Never Enough for all of the Hall of Fame Sports Awards. I mean, we're talking crazy. It was crazy. Wow. For George Foreman to be inducted into the Houston Sports Hall of Fame. So I no longer dislike the song.
Won't he do it? Won't he will?
Okay, you know what? I think we're going to do, because we've done four songs, right? One, two, two, two. Mm-hmm. Okay, you guys, before we go any further, we actually have an interview with none other than the director of The Bully Exposed, Richard Santiago. So Woo! I'm going to pull that up real quick, which I think, let's see what happens when I push all these buttons. Do, 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 do. Now it's going to be in my head forever. Never enough. Sorry.
It's never enough.
Okay.
Hey, Christina. How are you? Everybody, hello. How you doing? Vince Powell, thank you for joining with us. Thank you, guys. My name is Richard Santiago. I am the director of thebullyexposed.com, a 501c3 nonprofit organization. We're geared at helping survivors of bullying. And we've been doing that for 15 years through films. Films, especially now, are a very important part of our lives, right? Films catapult us to worlds unknown. Nonfiction films, or you might call them documentaries, can very easily take an innocent man or a person who's been convicted of a crime unjustly, make them innocent. It can also take us and change our point of view of what we think about life. And that's what we do at thebullyexposed.com. We create films, your stories about bullying and show them to the world. So when you give from your heart to thebullyexposed.com, that's what you're doing. We have a team of award-winning filmmakers ready to tell your story, ready to change people's point of view about bullying, because some people think it's not, it's just a pass, it's a way to of life, it's the way for people to bullying, they feel bullying is a way of life and that it's just a passing fad, and it's not. It's something very, very real. And that's what we do at The Bully Exposed. So the one other way that we also, at thebullyexposed.com, how we help, is we have a show called Live Feed with your host, Richard Santiago, where we talk to kids, parents, and adults from all over the world about bullying. So the best way to find out, and we have that show every day, So the best way to find out is to go on to Instagram, follow us at StopTheBullying_together, so that you're notified every time we start our show. Instagram will notify you. So that's definitely one way that we help out. So, and we have, not only do we have a bunch of videos where we answer kids' questions at our IGTV channel, and you're able to go into our archives, and I'm sure that there's a video there that will fit you and what you're going through with bullying. Now, before I close this, I do want to give a shout out to the Air Force Sergeants Association 1560 that we work closely with, and thank them for their time. And no one understands what the families go to of military, and me being a part of the military community that protects this great nation of ours. It's they're the unsung heroes, what the families have to do so that their moms or their dads can protect our nation. So shout out to them, and definitely a great shout out to Vince Powell, who weeks ago I did not know who he was. He did not know who we were, but he stepped in because there was a vacant spot here on this Versa, and it's making it an amazing Versa. The songs that we are hearing are amazing, and their voices are amazing. So thank you, Mr. Powell, for being a hero, because that's what we need more. People to step in when they see something, where they see a vacancy, to step in and fill that gap. So thank you so very much. Please give with your heart, and remember to be kind, and have a great day. Bye.
Thank you so much, Richard. Look at that. And he's telling the truth, you guys. Originally, there was another young lady that was going to do this with me, and she had to back out, which I totally understood. But then I was like, oh, my God, what am I going to do?
Right.
And she and I weren't even, she wasn't on necessarily a specific show. We were just going to sing some songs. And I'm like, Vincent?
It worked out.
It did. God, look at God.
I called her randomly.
You did. You called me random.
So.
Okay, here we go. Let me see here. 4, 5 is right here. Oh, no.
Is it you?
No. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I must have did it. What's your next one is? There's 5. And I'm, oh, here we go.
Okay,
here we go.
So this song, this is my
back with you live next here song. In Las Vegas.
I'll explain it later.
One of the guys tonight. Next up to perform is someone whose performance last week had the judges on their feet.
Nicki Minaj,
can you do it again?
Vincent,
let's find out.
I think my last performance was like one of my best performances ever.
Vincent! Wow!
The judge comments were all good, except, you know, Nicki, I'm still trying to figure that one out.
I can envision a whole bunch of 50-year-olds and 40-year-olds throwing their panties at you.
But you know, panties are good here and there every once in a while, huh? I think the number one thing that I have to do tonight is perform, leave all the emotions, nervousness, all this stuff on the side. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nobody got time for that. You gotta bring it, or you going home.
Here we go.
We belong together, and you know.
The story behind that song.
Tell us the story.
Okay. I was sick as a dog.
Okay.
So like that whole week before, my throat was like swollen, like I was bleeding from my throat. Oh. And so also my roommate Lazaro, I'm gonna say his name because he knows who he is. He was my roommate. I said I was gonna do Feeling Good, and he picked the song after me. And so we had to do a coin toss, and he won the toss.
No. And I'm feeling good.
Yes. Rah, rah. And so I had to switch everything. I was sick. Oh, I was just like, God. Whatever. And then my brother was like, do not do End of the Road because you sent in mixed signs and it's going to be the end of the road. And it was. Here you go.
Oh, my gosh. Okay. I hate that, y'all. Song selection, y'all think it's like we just picking what we like. It is such a challenging thing. Especially because I would go and look and see if someone else sang it last year. You know what I mean? Or the years before. Because then people remember. And they're like, she's singing that song that Michelle sang last year. And I like her better. And you're just... Right. So trying to get fresh, fun.
The true fans.
Yeah, true fans. The TV shows.
They know.
I want to say real quick a shout out to Allie. I know Allie's on here. Do you have anybody that you know for sure is on here that you want to give a... What's up? How you doing? Oh, look at this.
Preston,
hey, on Vincent's feed, baby. We got anybody on the Facebook we want to say hey to?
Sandy,
hi, Sandy. I love you. I miss you so much.
What's up, Maria?
What's up, Maria?
Cece.
Michelle. Hey, Lachelle. Hey, girl. Okay, here we go. Here is my third audition for America's Got Talent. This is my favorite audition performance.
Look at me. I am changing.
Support, girl, support.
Seeing everything so clean. I'm changing. And I'm gonna start right now, right?
They made it for me.
I'm hoping.
See, look at her, she's shining.
To work it out. And I know that I can. But I need you. I need a hand. How many good friends have I already lost? How many dark nights have I known? Walking down that wrong road, there was nothing I could find. All those years of darkness could make a person blind. I am changing. Yes, I know. I'm gonna start again. I'm gonna leave my past behind.
Look at her point. She points too.
I'll change my life. I'll make a vow and nothing's gonna stop me.
I'm sorry, I got excited. She was belting.
No, that's good.
So let me tell y'all. I picked this song. And I sang it to them and they were like, yes. It was the first time they were ever like, 100%. And when I was a little girl, Hold on, I have feelings. When I was a little girl, I used to dream of being Effie White in Dreamgirls. And I used to sing this song. I've sang that song since I was probably 15 or 16 years old in my bedroom. And I would practice it and practice it and practice it. And I was obsessed. I've been obsessed with Dreamgirls my whole life. Like, we're your Dreamgirls, boy. Like, all of it. And whenever they said I could sing this, and I sang this in front of 16 million people, I looked up the viewership for this episode. I was like, as she says it, I'm going to make a vow. Nothing's going to stop me. I'm going to change my life. And I did when I sang that. And I was like, I'm done. I want to go home. Because it's so stressful. Different. It's so stressful. And I was so happy, you guys. Like, singing that song, I was so happy. I was on cloud nine. I got a standing ovation from the judges. Oh, it was so delicious, right? And you leave and see, you know, everybody's stressed out. And so half of them were like, we're getting cut. And I was like, bum, 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 bum. Because I knew I was good. Because you know.
Yeah.
Oh, so many feelings. I have so many feelings about this audition. It was one of the highest moments, I think, of my life.
Oh, wow.
Because people say having their children. But I didn't, like, my children are their own people. And having them, you know what I'm saying? I didn't, like, sew them together. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that wasn't an achievement. Right, it was a blessing. But this, for me, was, like, my whole life achievement. Like, my dreams came true. I literally crossed some of my biggest bucket list items off of right around this time. Wow. So, okay, next up, American Idol.
What's next?
I love you, Christina.
I love you too, baby.
So this next song, I perform it every year at the Miller Outdoor Theater.
Oh, you do at the Motown
at the
show.
Motown Review. And
tell them about it.
The first time they told me, I want you to do this Lenny Williams song, I was like, I don't think I should do it. But then I finally did it, and I've been doing it ever since. And even Lenny Williams, he knows I do it. He's like, oh my God, I love it. So I got a prop from him. So
let's do this.
Girl, you know I love you. No matter what you do.
Productions give you props.
Yeah, they do it every year in May, right around Memorial Day weekend. Yep. So
learning soul and the meaning, music where it comes from,
yes,
and being able to deliver it to people, yes, is amazing.
Well, this man,
You need some tennis shoes. Oh, you got them on for runs because you be running.
Oh, yeah.
I don't do all that. My voice is, I always say my voice is like a Mack truck and she turns slow and hard. But you, you got, it's like,
I want to be like her.
No. You have an amazing instrument. Your falsetto. Can y'all drop some hearts if you feeling that falsetto he just hit? I know some glass was breaking at y'all's house.
Come on, and this is the powerhouse. Come on. Shoot. We trying to make it.
Shoot, she yells. Quit letting that woman yell into the microphone. No, I'm just kidding.
Nah, okay. I feel it.
You guys, we got 15 minutes left before Instagram kicks us right up on this live. So, number one, have you gone and followed at @StopTheBullying_together? I think that's right. Richard posted in the comments to make sure if I did it right. And if you haven't had a chance, go over to Cash App. Takes just a second. $TheBullyExposed2. That is what we are doing this for, to raise awareness for The Bully Exposed, a nonprofit organization, if you're just joining us, that helps the survivors, not the victims, the survivors, because we're survivors of bullying. And that's a really important subject to both Vincent and I. So do that for us. It will make us so happy. Before I play on my next song, do you have something coming up that people need to know about? You got some music out that people need to know about? Do you have something you want to share with everybody?
Well,
now that you say so, Priscilla.
Now that you say it, something.
Uh-huh.
So I got an album coming out, hopefully at the beginning of the year, but I'm dropping a single at the beginning of next month called Best Love. And it's my first soul R&B album. Like I said, I've been trying to, I'm a church boy. I sing at church. I got Christian music everywhere. But we're taking a little detour. And we get the music video in New York, so we've been hustling for it. I've been working on this album for 3 years, so it gotta be just right. It's gonna come out on all platforms. The album will come out at the beginning of the year, but this will be October 1st, at the beginning of the month.
So October 1st, they can see this video.
Yes.
January.
The whole album.
Y'all hear me? October 1st. Go ahead and put a little quick calendar reminder, you know, on your iCalendar. October 1st, he gonna be real sexy in this video. You're gonna see him on the social medias. And if you want to follow him, I have followed him. He's on Spotify. He's Apple Music. It's gonna be on all that stuff. Everything. And also, I wanted to share with you guys a little something. Your big girl here having a concert. October the 11th. Oh, hey, that's my remix I'm working on, baby. That remix is going to be premiered live at my concert October the 11th, 7:30. If you want to get your tickets, you can go to ChristinaWells.com/live. If you want to support me, this is the way. This is the way. You want to hear me sing? This is the way. ChristinaWells.com/live, 7:30 p.m. Central Standard Time. Look, I'm going to take it right back and do that one more time.
Come on now.
Because I love this video. David, I love you, David. This video is amazing. Yes, add that event to your calendar. October the 11th, 7:30 p.m. And you never know. If you buy one of these tickets, I might be sending you a little surprise. $15. $15. And you're going to be on a Sunday evening. Knock me up. Come on. Woo. I'm coming ready or not, baby. Yes. Live.ChristinaWells.com or ChristinaWells.com/live. Both of those will work. Let me see how much time we have left. Oh, we got 10 minutes. I got one more song I can sing. Here we go. So I'm going to show you guys my very last audition. I'm going to talk to you about my feelings about it. Y'all ready for that? If not, I'm just kidding. So my favorite thing about America's Got Talent was they really listened to me when it came to how I wanted to dress. I really, you can tell I have a style. It's a sequined, glitterific style. And so these dresses that I wore in these last two auditions or performances, they actually made them for me. So I was very grateful for that. So this is me singing Natural Woman, which is a song I sing all the time, but I sing it in the key of A, right? Looking out on the morning rain. And they had me sing it in the original key of C, which was a little bit of a stretch for me, but they were like, wait, you could do it. You could do it. You got it. And I was like, okay. And this isn't my most favorite performance, but I'm going to play it for you because I'm that strong now. I'm past all those feelings of bitterness. She says with a smile on her face. Here we go.
Looking out on the morning rain.
But that dress though, right?
I used to feel so inspired. And when I knew I had to face another day.
Good though.
Before the day I met you, life was so unkind, but now the key to my peace of mind, cause you made me feel,
right there, did you hear it? Yeah! So from there, I have two other busted notes.
But you look good, though.
I look so good, and I still have that dress. And don't you know, I wear it. And I also learned an important lesson. I'm going to tell y'all right now. After I had this performance, I went into the bathroom backstage, and I cried for like 20 minutes. Because I had had my most intimate fear realized, which was to get the opportunity to sing on television and to mess up. It is your biggest fear. You will get your chance, right? And then you will fail or you will mess up and you won't be perfect. And I thought perfection was my goal. I'm so glad this happened though, because I learned, first of all, stand up for yourself, Christina. If you don't sing something in a certain key, say something, right? Not once, which I did. I said it once and they were like, that would be a lot of stuff for us to re-record some of the track. And I was like, okay. Exactly, right? But now I'd be like, well, that's the only way I can sing it, or we need to do a different song, because if it's high, and for those of you who aren't singers, like if I'm singing down in my normal key, you make me feel, I have all my abilities. It's what I call my sweet spot, right? Between like D on the staff down to like a G, I could belt every one of those notes just beautiful every day, all the time. You get above the D. You get up in the E, F, G, A range, and then it's, you make me. It's not where my power is. Right, and so if I'm tired, if I haven't had enough water, and you know what I'm talking about, you have to really feed and take care of your voice like a pet if you want to do stuff outside of your normal skill set. Like, I think we see this in Idina Menzel. She's had a couple things where she's like in Frozen, the first Frozen, that she sings that super high note, which was like a perfect day for her, but she never was able to redo that live again. Yeah, and I mean, I'm not judging. That's like, I'm a singer. I've had it happen too. Here is where it happened. So we're human beings. Yeah, like she's had how many Broadway shows under her belt where she sang perfect?
Right.
Then you get in the studio or you get on a show or something and someone convinces you like, yeah, girl, take it to the top of your range, all the way to the edge. And you're like, okay, I could do it. But can you do it every day on tour?
No.
So I want to tell you, looking out on the morning rain, I used to feel so uninspired. And when I knew I had to face another day, Lord, it made me feel so tired. Before the day I met you, life was so unkind, but you're the key to my peace of mind. Cause you make me feel, you make me feel, you make me feel like a natural woman. See, he can sing higher than I can. So we want to thank you guys so much for watching. You are amazing, Vincent. I love you.
I'm over here. I was trying to buy a ticket to make me create an account. That's why I was looking.
Yeah, you got to create an account if you're going to, because I need your email address. So I can know about you. I love you and I want to be your friend forever. So first of all, thank you so much to Vincent.
Yes.
He came in on the end and he has been so gracious and so kind. Such a talented man. So fantastic. You can go to his website, which is vincentpowell.net, or you can go to his Instagram and his Facebook page. He has an amazing following. He puts out beautiful music, great videos. And October 1st, you're going to see that new music coming out. Tell him the name of the song.
Best Love.
Because that's what he gives. Hey! Girl.
Hey, thank you.
Hello.
Friends forever. No, I'm
going. All right. And if you guys don't mind, ChristinaWells.com/live. I would love it if you watched the Christina Wells concert. I would love it if you supported me. The ticket's only $15. And if you buy one, you might get a surprise in your email inbox from me. You never know. So, TheBullyExposed.com. I hope that everyone has a little more awareness of what they do. I hope everyone takes it a little more seriously whenever you see someone making fun of someone else, or when you see somebody who is being a bully or being aggressive towards someone. You don't have to go and be like, don't do that, but just don't be okay with it. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you're just not okay with it, if you just say anything to the people around you, and a few people who say, hey, that's not cool, you'd be real surprised how quick a bully will step down. Because oftentimes bullies just want to feel cool. That's why they're doing that. They feel powerless in their lives and they're looking for a way to feel more powerful. So if you remove that power source by telling them we don't all like it, you'd be surprised. Oftentimes it can help. Not every time, and I know that, but oftentimes it can. So TheBullyExposed.com, Cash App, TheBullyExposed #2 if you want to give a donation, or go over to their Instagram page at StopBullying_together. Richard has put it in the comments. If you want to scroll, you can find it. Follow Vincent on his journey. Please attend my concert. We appreciate you guys so much. Yeah?
Yes.
And I think, who won this versus? Who do you think won?
Christina!
No, Chad. You know who won? Who won?
Oh, the Bully.
TheBullyExposed.com. Chad, no, I did not win nothing. She stopped her video in the middle of the end like, don't play that.
I'm going to give it to her.
No, I'm going to give it to you. The day I can go, look, I can't even get none of that stuff.
Look.
Thank you, everybody. We love you guys. Thank you so much. Mwah, 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 mwah. Have a great night. Be safe. Sanitize.
And don't forget to donate. I'm gonna post. I'm gonna keep.
Wear
posting.
Your mask.
Yeah.
Be careful, right? We've been quarantining. Be careful with yourselves, okay?
What's the Cash App?
Cash App. The Bully Exposed #2. So just put a 2.
And then say Richard.
Uh-huh. Then it should say Richard. Mm-hmm. And then you'll just give them. Child, if all of you gave $1.
Yep.
If everyone gave $1 to each other, we'd all be. I mean, it's just amazing.
Yep.
Yeah?
Yep.
Okay, guys. Here, my happy hold that.
Peace out.
Peace out. Love, riches, and all happiness.